I'm Jeff Fisher, and this is a short introductory video on using the .NET Client Library with Google Data APIs. Let's get started. First, you have to download the SDK from our code.google.com page at this URL. I've already downloaded the SDK, so let's install it. For this demo, I'm using Microsoft Visual C# 2008 Express Edition, which is free, and a good way to get started. However, the SDK assumes we're using Visual Studio 2005, so we have to copy the project templates. If you're using Visual Studio 2005, you don't have to do this step. Now that we've done that, we can go ahead and open Visual Studio. Since we have these templates, creating a new project is easy. If we just go to New Project, we can create a Google Picasa project with one click. This creates a new blank project with some code for us. It also creates a dialog box for the user to log in. If you look at the code behind this, let me first discuss some of the high-level principles of our client library. The client library is organized into the following components. There is the service class, which deals with the connection to the API. There are query classes, which allow us to construct particular queries against the API. And there are also feed and entry classes that contain the data model. In this simple example, we first create a new service class. Then we get our login information from the form provided by the template. And then we're able to create a new album query. And then we get back a feed of all of the user's albums. Looping through this feed gives us a number of entries which contain information about each album that the user has. We are then able to update a GUI element with information about these albums and then display it to the user. Let's run this example. First, I have to log in. And now you can see each of the albums in my test account along with the number of photos that are in each album. That's a simple way to get started, but perhaps you want a more detailed code example to copy. For that, we can go into the SDK directory in our Start menu and open up the sample solution. Again, since we're using 2008, we have to quickly convert the existing solution. Now that we've done that, we can see that there are a number of samples provided for us. The first one I'd like to show is the photo browser. This is an advanced form of the demo that we saw earlier. Again, we have to log in. Again, we see the list of albums, but this time we can see the album cover and double-click to see each photo inside of the album. All of this code is open source and available for you to use in your own applications. One other sample I'd like to show you is the DocList Uploader. If we go ahead and set this as a startup project, this sample allows us to quickly log in to Google Docs. See our existing docs, open them, and also upload new ones by dragging and dropping. Again, this sample is open source, and you can see all of the code. Now that we've gone through some of the samples and gotten you started compiling your own application, let's talk about some of the resources that are available to help you develop. All of our resources are available on code.google.com, starting at the project page for the .NET Client Library. Besides downloading the SDK, you can also view the documentation. The documentation includes a JavaDoc style reference for all of the classes, members, constructors, and objects used in the client library. We also have a number of developer guides for each particular API that walk you through each operation that can be performed. Lastly, if you have any questions, we have a discussion group available for you to ask any questions, concerns, or request any features that are not currently available. Thanks for watching this video. I hope that you'll create some interesting applications and share them with us.